All right, thank you so much, Leiwa. She's broken down barriers as the first American Samoan woman to serve on Congress and just one of two female combat veterans to hold the position as well. Tulsi Gabbard joining us this
morning.
Thank you for being with us. Okay, well, this week the omnibus spending bill was approved by Congress for the 2016 budget. Well, a lot of areas getting money for here in Hawaii. Is there any one particular area that you feel may have got a little shortchanged at all?
Actually, I think this overall was a win for the country and a win for Hawaii, because when you look at what the alternative was and where we've been in the past, in 2013, Hawaii suffered pretty badly when the government shut down. There were a lot of concerns about the effects of sequester on federal funding across the board, but in particular on our military funding here in Hawaii, which is such a critical driver of our economy. So the good thing about what was passed was it averted a government shutdown. It averted drastic reductions in funding across the board to include the military at the sequester level funding, but it also included some important tax credits. A few of them I'd like to talk about is the earned income tax credit and the child care tax credit. This is affecting those who need help the most, low-income families. And when you think about the fact that 1 in 8 children in Hawaii are living in extreme poverty, these credits are going exactly where they need to go, and these were made permanent. So in the past, these were temporarily extended, maybe year by year, even shorter time lengths, but at least now that these have been made permanent, there's some certainty. There were also tax credits passed for small businesses, whether it's for research, for investment in capital, investment in equipment, and these kind of things. These I've heard from a lot of small businesses in Hawaii, are very helpful, and again, provide certainty so that they can plan not just year by year, but you know, okay, look, if I got to make a big purchase, I can decide if I need to do it this year or maybe in 4 years or 5 years. So there's a whole lot. I encourage people, if you have questions or if we can help, if you are a small business owner, if you're looking to see how you can qualify for these tax credits, give my office a call and we can help you kind of navigate through this big, huge bill that was passed.
Yeah, of course, those special businesses or those local businesses so needed here in Hawaii.
Yes.
Now, let's turn our focus to the Iraq right now. Ground forces reclaiming Ramadi this morning, a major key in the war against ISIS. You have said the U.S. needs to help end this war as quickly as possible, of course. Yeah. What strategy would you like to see implemented right now?
Well, I think the first and most important thing is the United States needs to do more than help end this war. We need to be very focused on our enemy, which is ISIS, Al-Qaeda, and these other Islamic extremist groups that are posing a threat to the United States and frankly, to civilization as a whole. If you look at the different countries, Iraq, Syria, Libya, if you look at these different countries where these Islamic extremist groups have taken hold, the strategy may differ slightly in each of these different areas, and we've got to look at what exactly works. But the problem that I've seen so far is there doesn't appear to be that mission focus. Instead, in Syria, for example, the current policy is counterproductive, because on the one hand, the United States is waging a war to overthrow the Syrian government of Assad, which I believe is illegal because Congress hasn't declared that war. And it's counterproductive because it's working and helping to achieve the exact same objective that ISIS and Al-Qaeda want. They'd love to see this government overthrown so that they can step in, take over all of Syria, creating an even worse humanitarian crisis and presenting a greater threat to the world. We should end that illegal war and focus on the war to defeat and destroy ISIS.
Well, let's end here on a much lighter note. You are here enjoying your Christmas break.
Yes.
You just mentioned off camera that you had a chance to go out surfing. So let's play a quick game that relates to that. It's kind of a who would you rather?
Oh boy.
Okay, you're a surfer.
Yeah.
Large set comes in. You find yourself competing for a wave. Who would you rather give the wave to, cut off, or hold their head underwater? Your options: Bernie Sanders, Ted Cruz, Donald Trump.
Oh, man. Cut off Donald Trump, because I just think it would be fun. I don't know. Give the wave to Bernie Sanders. He's been going through a little bit of a rough time here. I'm not going to hold anyone's head underwater. That's just mean and
all
cruel.
Right.
So I'm going to take a pass on that one.
All right. You're not very well said. Very well said. Thank
Thanks,
you so
Mike.
Much, Tulsi.
Good to see you.
Yeah, good to see you. All right. Stick around. Your top morning headlines are coming up after the break.